second symptom set of schizophrenia is disorganised speech, which is another positive symptom. Unlike delusions, this symptom set reflects a disturbance in the form of thought as opposed to the content of thought. Now, you might be thinking, what's speech got to do with thought? Actually, you only have to think about it for a moment to realise how interconnected these two are. Unless you have some sort of magical device, you cannot know what is going on in the mind of the person next to you, or the mind of anybody, in fact. Speech, the words that people say and the way in which they say them, is the closest reflection we have of somebody's thoughts and thought processes. To some extent, of course, a person's behaviour is also a reflection of their thought processes. But speech is generally the best approximation that we have. When somebody's thoughts, the form and the process of them, are very disorganised and disturbed, their speech is also going to be affected. Have you ever had the experience of being really tired and feeling like your thoughts are a bit scrambled? Sometimes, when I'm very tired, I might find it difficult to think of the exact word I want to say to express myself. Let's say I'm trying to ask one of my kids to pass me the dictionary, but I can't think of the word dictionary. Instead, I might ah for a bit before eventually saying something like, oh, you know, that book that tells us what words mean. In this example, I'm tired, my thoughts are a bit jumbled, and my speech is reflecting that. This sort of thing can happen for all of us from time to time. For people with schizophrenia, though, their speech disturbance involves prolonged patterns of disorganised speech that are much more extreme. Now, there are lots of ways in which speech can be disordered. The first speech disturbance I want to explain to you is a neologism. This is when a person makes up a word. This word has no meaning in mainstream language, and it's often a combination of two words that do have recognised meaning, or a distortion of a word that has meaning. The word webinar is one example of a neologism. However, because this is a word that is now largely accepted in mainstream speech, by definition, it actually ceases to be a neologism. Another example would be if I said, I'm going for a bike ride on the slide rope. Slide rope is a neologism made up of two words that separately have accepted and recognised meaning, but together are meaningless. The speech disturbance that I like best, just because it's kind of exactly what it sounds like, is word salad. Because what do you do to a salad? The very last thing you do to it before you put it on the table? You toss it. Word salad is basically a bunch of words tossed together. It makes no sense and has no meaning. If I were to say, dirty Mark ran wood projectile apple banana boss's baby, that would be an example of word salad. It means nothing. It's a reflection of chaotic thought processes. Tangentiality reflects a disturbance in a person's associative thought patterns. They might start off talking about one topic and then move to another topic that has little apparent relevance to the original topic. Interestingly, most of us from time to time can actually demonstrate slightly tangential speech. For example, you might be talking with a friend and planning to watch a movie together. Talking about movies makes you think about the last time you saw a movie in the cinemas, so you might then begin talking about the movie that you saw on that occasion. You have moved, in the context of your conversation, to a topic that, for you, is associated with the original topic, even though it may have little direct relevance to the original topic. Generally speaking, though, in this kind of example, most of us manage to return to the original topic of conversation fairly quickly. In addition, we know that we have digressed from the original topic. In other words, we have insight into what we have done. As a diagnostic symptom for schizophrenia, tangentiality is much more extreme. Other differences include a failure to return to the original topic of conversation and a lack of insight into this behaviour. For example, the association between the original and second topics is typically less substantial. Often the link for the individual might be a single word only. Let's go back to our movie example. Imagine that you're talking to a friend who has schizophrenia about watching the Audrey Hepburn classic, Breakfast at Tiffany's. If your friend is demonstrating tangentiality, they might start talking about a girl called Tiffany they knew in primary school. This might then lead them to tell you the names of all the schools they've ever attended. Before you know it, the conversation has moved a very long way from the original topic. And if you leave it up to your friend, it's unlikely that you will ever return to the original topic.